Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome back to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. We're here with author Kevin Sampsell. So was writing the book or seeing it published, did that help with, would you say that it induced more anxiety, or did it lessen those feelings of anxiousness?
I think that it was more of a cathartic experience to write about this stuff. It was pretty difficult to write some of the parts in the book. I feel like that it's the stories are something that a lot of people can relate to, you know. Maybe not exactly the same as other people's stories, but other people have things that happen in their family that they're ashamed of or that it's hard to talk about. The end result is, you know, after the book has been out now for a few weeks, it's been really great. The reaction has been really good. I've been getting emails and Facebook messages like pretty much every day from different people talking about how much they can relate to the book, and I hear people say pretty often, like, we had similar childhoods, you know, and it's always strange to hear that, because you always kind of think, like, you know, your childhood was pretty ordinary and stuff. But I think maybe that's part of the appeal of the book too, is that there's kind of this ordinary quality to some of the stories that people relate to, but there's you know, there's other strange threads.
The book is it's told in a series of vignettes, almost interstitial segments strung together, woven into this sort of an overarching tapestry. You know, that's like 9 different metaphors that I've crammed into one there. But it's in a series of snapshots, basically. Mm. Were you drawn to that format naturally? Did it just come out that way, or was there a particular reason that you chose that device?
I started off when I was first starting to write the book. I wrote some of the parts of the book quite a while ago, like 9 years ago, and I was sort of writing them as experiments, like trying to remember things from my memory, and just so I would just write whatever I remembered, and sometimes there wasn't a lot of details, you know, but it was kind of fun for me to do that, and so I just wanted to do that as much as I could. So when I was working on the book, I would make a list of just odd little stories I remember throughout my childhood, you know. And then I would sit down to write them, and I would just, you know, I would just write as much as I could remember. And a lot of times it would be like one paragraph, or sometimes it would be 2 pages. I think that's just the way memory works when you're trying to remember certain things from your childhood, you know.
Writing something that, material that is at times so dark, do you enjoy the process of writing in and of itself for its own sake, or is it just a means to the end of having written?
I don't know if I enjoy the writing while I'm writing. Sometimes it kind of depends on what it is. With this book, it was pretty tough to, like I said, it was pretty tough to write some of the parts, I feel like it's more of a rewarding kind of thing when you're done and you can actually see that it's finished, and when the book comes out, it's just like a big sigh of relief. It's a lot. It's not that enjoyable to be in the midst of writing.
My wife often says that she doesn't enjoy exercising, she just enjoys having exercised. So
yeah, it's kind of like that. Yeah.
We come back, we'll talk about some of your other work, Future Tense Publishing, which I will attempt to say correctly in the next segment, and the concept of Portland Noir. We are talking to Mr. Kevin Sampsell. You're watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay there.